go to File, Import, SVG. Now do a right click and convert to Grease Pencil. In this episode I want to show you how to export an SVG with colors from Adobe Illustrator and import it to Blender 2.9. After this I will convert the imported SVG to a Grease Pencil object. During this process I hit some discrepancies and I will show you how I solved those. As always, if you have any better solution, please write this to the comments below. And subscribe to this YouTube channel for more videos. Some rules first. Only export vectors. Don't try to import gradients, appearance effects or images. Not converted strokes will be automatically transformed to surfaces. Open paths will be closed by default. If you observe those rules, then go to Data, Save As, SVG. You have to select SVG Profile 1.1 or 1.2 in SVG options if you want to export color information as well. When you choose SVG 1.1, then you have to go to Expand Options and CSS Properties. Choose Presentation Attributes, then hit OK. Importing SVG is very simple. Go to Data, Import, Scalable Vector Graphics, SVG. Select your exported SVG in the proper folder, then hit OK. As usual, the imported file is very tiny. When you check the outliner or the properties, then you see that Blender transformed the vector graphic to a curve and all my surfaces are single objects. If you don't want that, then you have to create a compound path in Illustrator first and then export it again. Consider that you only should compound paths with same color or logical group of vectors. In one of my previous tutorials I showed you how to convert a curve to mesh. Today I want to show you how to convert a curve to Grease Pencil. Select your curve and do a right click, Convert to Grease Pencil. Or go to Object, Convert to Grease Pencil from Curve, Mesh. With both options you will get this result, which isn't what I expected. If you just want to work with the curve itself as a stroke line, then you have the possibility to go to Material, New Material, just select Stroke and keep Fill disabled. Go to Edit Mode, select All, and assign the material to your surface. For sure you are able to adjust thickness or fill spaces with the fill tool. But my main question is, why do I lose the surface generally when I convert to a Grease Pencil object? I made a lot of tests and I didn't find a reason why it's not working. It isn't the form of exporting SVGs, but I found a solution for myself in Blender and it is kind of a workaround. I start again with the imported SVG curves. Right click and convert to mesh. Yes, I know, it is not a Grease Pencil object, but wait a moment. Result is a very ugly mesh geometry. I will only merge vertices by distance right now. Okay, now I want to convert to Grease Pencil, but when I do a right click, then there is no Convert to Grease Pencil option anymore. But if you go to Object, Convert to, then you find Grease Pencil from Curve Mesh. Again, this looks very weird, so I expand this little setting box here. It is necessary to bring threshold angle and stroke offset to 0, and if you want, thickness to 1. This worked for me. I checked this by assigning a new material to it. Now it should be a usable Grease Pencil object and you are able to adjust materials, working with the object data properties or layers, and it is possible to use the fill tool here as well. For sure you can add further brush strokes to this now or switch to sculpt mode and adjust the vertices. I guess the object is hopefully prepared for your needs now. The generated triangles from Convert to Mesh destroys the grease pencil object when you switch to edit mode. This is really frustrating when you want to select and move single points. My solution for this was to remove all the edges before you convert to a grease pencil object. Clean everything and fill the hole. For revision, first convert your curve to mesh. Remove doubles and clean up the surface. This really depends on your complexity of your objects. At least convert to grease pencil. Probably there are more issues, but I haven't found more so far. In the end, I want to tell you that I had some troubles with importing SVG to Blender. Sometimes it happened, the Blender doesn't implement every form as it should from Illustrator. I have no experience or chance to test this with Inkscape. This is a very specific case and there was no quick result findable in the web. I haven't found a solution to prevent this. I checked all settings in Adobe Illustrator as well, but it doesn't help. If someone knows how to solve this, please let us know in the comments below. I will pin the answer. Thank you very much for watching. It would be very nice to give this video a like and or subscribe to our YouTube channel for more game dev videos. Cheers!